Good evening. On behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of Weir High School, I would like to congratulate the class of 2020. This class will be remembered not just for the extraordinary circumstances under which they graduated, but also for the extraordinary achievements of their 4 years. Out of our graduating class of 153 students, we have a West Virginia University Foundation scholar, many students who have signed to play collegiate athletics, 33 Promise Scholars, that's one out of every five, and 31 students who've graduated with highest honors. We're so proud of all of our graduates and for all of their accomplishments. We also commend our graduates for their persistence in the face of adversity, resiliency, and hard work. This class has definitely cemented its place in your high school history. I would also like to thank all of you for your patience with us and for your support over the last 4 years. If it wasn't for all of you and your love and support, the students wouldn't be here today. I would now like to introduce Ms. Olivia Dowler, who will deliver the highest honors address on behalf of our graduates. To the class who was born in the wake of 9/11, to the class whose last months were taken by a pandemic, to the class of 2020, I'd like to begin by extending a collective thanks to all the teachers, coaches, and faculty of your high school. Thank you to all the families of those graduates and anyone else who pushed us forward. We wouldn't be here today without your support. 4 years at Weir High is a difficult experience to sum up in a matter of minutes. Each person would have a different thing to say. I like to think of it as a basket full of seemingly random objects. The first of these objects is a small toy train. To me, this mostly represents coming into our freshman year. As a whole, we knew that we were going to come and leave our mark in this school in one way or another. We may not have known in what direction we were going, or how we were going to approach it, but we knew that we were going in headstrong and with full force. The second of these objects is a piece of rope. To someone who has just stumbled upon this basket, this may seem to be the most insignificant object, but to us, we know it is the most important. This rope represents the challenges that we have faced, the knots we've undone that at one point we may have believed would have our hands tied behind our backs forever. These challenges will look different for each of us. Physical or mental illness, bullying, addiction, grief. The third of these objects is a handheld mirror. With this, we can see ourselves and see everything that is behind us. We can see everything in our background that has made us the people who we are in that reflection today. While it is important to reflect on our past, both achievements and setbacks, it is equally important to remember to put down the mirror and pick up the fourth object. The final object in the basket is a flashlight. With this flashlight, we can do two things. We can shed light on the things behind us, the things we've overcome and the people who've helped us to ensure that they are not forgotten. The second thing we can do is shine this light ahead of us. Bring to light your future plans and aspirations. Show the world your dreams of stepping into that classroom, that hospital, that courtroom, that field, or that line of service. Wherever you go, this basket will follow you. Be sure to continue to fill it for the rest of your lives. This next part, I tried many times to write down, even last night, and I just couldn't put it into words. There are not words to describe what we are facing currently in our nation. Us, the graduates of the Weir High Class of 2020, are accepting the roles of the leaders of today. As the leaders of today, we need to make sure that we speak up for those whose voices may not be heard. Those of minorities, those Appalachian voices, LGBTQ voices, Black voices, women's voices, all must be heard, and I know as leaders that we are going to bring these to light. Congratulations and thank you, Weir High Class of 2020.
Thank you.
our graduates for the evening, and I would have just had Olivia stay out here and didn't realize she was first in the alphabetical order, so she's getting her steps in. First, we have Olivia Dowler. Olivia is the highest honors graduate, and she's also a member of National Honor Society. Congratulations. Autumn Duckworth.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you.